Hey guys, it's Buddha here. I'm back. This is just an update on my MRI results that I got yesterday. Unfortunately, there's no good news in this. It turns out that my fibroid is intramural, meaning that instead of the fibroid having an outside location, you know, outside of the walls of the uterus, is embedded within the uterine walls, which was something that I was hoping and praying that I didn't have. And the problem with it is that it makes surgery impossible because my gynecologist feels that the concern about this surgery is that it may not be enough uterine muscle to reconstruct if they was to remove this fibroid. And not only that, it's already an impossibility for fertility right now. I'm saying right now because I'm very optimistic. You know, it really took me a minute to put this video up because yesterday I was just not in the right state of mind. I pretty much had an emotional breakdown yesterday because, you know, just the thought of the possibility of not being able to bear children was running through my mind and I went nuts. I lost it. And I'm sure any woman who's going through my situation would do the same thing. You know, I'm just not used to taking news in that way, like a grain of salt and just brush it off my shoulders. I couldn't, you know. And this is a special case because I could see if I had children already and I was in this situation, then it would be different. I would be like, okay, fine. But being that I'm 28, never had children or anything of that sort, he considered it a special case. He never actually dealt with this situation before. So, he gave options like, there's non-surgical procedures that I can go for. But the ones that he mentioned, like getting shot with Depo-Provera, which is this medication where it puts your body into a menopause-like state and it shrinks the fibroid, but if he takes me off, it's going to grow back. And the side effect to it is that because it puts you in a menopausal state, it can affect your bones and possibly give you osteoporosis. Another option was uterine artery immobilization, which he told me is not recommended for women who wants to have children. But according to my research, I've seen women who've had this procedure, never had any problems with bleeding anymore, never had any problems with bearing children. I don't know where he's getting his information from. Maybe some women have had to. Maybe some women did go through that. I'm not saying no. But I don't know. That to me, I feel like that's the most effective. If I was to go that route, to me, that would be more effective than him just going in and trying to take this fibroid out and not being able to reconstruct my uterus. I'm not gonna risk that. And another concern is that this fibroid is leaning on my right ureter, on my kidney, on my right side. And that's one of the main concerns because it can cause a possible backflow of urine back into my kidneys, causing an infection. I can end up losing my kidney if I don't get something done about this. So it's kind of a ticking time bomb situation. And not only was I looking up, you know, I do research of my own too, which is what I recommend to anybody who's in any kind of situation that's probing surgery. And especially in a situation where you're dealing with a fibroid that's intramural, where it's embedded in your uterine walls. That's a serious problem. Because what it does, the bigger it gets, it can affect your bladder, it can affect your intestines, causing you to become constipated, it can affect your kidneys. You know, it's a big deal. It's not just something that you could just cut away. It's a serious procedure. It's a serious situation. And it's rough. But I've been doing research on of a more naturalistic approach to this. And I've seen that, according to what I was looking up, I've seen that a lot of women were successful in bearing children and shrinking their fibroids naturally just by changing their diets overall. And I know it's hard for us, you know, growing up in a certain lifestyle where we're so used to eating foods that are high in cholesterol and, you know, getting a Thanksgiving dinner on and, you know, those big dinner type things. And that's very common in our, you know, in black families, you know, amongst us. You know, that's something that's really common. And when you're so used to that, you don't really think of your health. You just think of, oh, this food is good, and you just go on about your life. But when it gets to a point where things start going wrong and you're getting older, you start to question. I mean, you should question yourself on, well, maybe it's the things that I'm eating that's causing these, you know, causing such and such in the first place. You know, whatever we do from young affects us later on in life. And it may not affect us right away, but it will. And I strongly believe that, I mean, to doctors, they think that fibroids are a mystery. Oh, it's just smooth muscle. No, I don't think it's just that. I strongly believe, according to my mindset, I believe that fibroids are nothing but a ball of toxic waste that sits in your body. Because, think about it, anything, if any of us who are so into, like, eating fast food a lot, I mean, just think about all these these artificial hormone processed foods that we're putting into our bodies, and you know, these hormones are affecting us in a negative way where we're not able to expel these toxins. It's going to get embedded into our bodies, and it could be anywhere. It can affect your hair, your skin, it can affect your internal organs, your kidneys, your intestines, your liver. It can affect any part of your body, including the uterus. So I strongly encourage you guys to start going organic.